All right, everybody, Coach Kilburn again with part three of our video series, preparing for our industry standard certification in Adobe InDesign CC. All right, let's see if we can wrap this up in this third video. So guys, they may ask you to create some new presets, right? And they'll tell you everything you need to do to create that preset. So where do we go? We go to File, go down to Document Presets, and then we want to define a new document preset. Okay, guys, you can click here. They'll tell you what to name it, right? They may tell you the intent, print, web, or mobile. They may tell you the number of pages. They may tell you whether to have a primary text frame or not, facing pages. They'll give you the size, they'll give you the width and the height, the increments, the columns, the bleed, the slug, the margins. Guys, they will give you everything in the question. Just make sure you read the question, okay? Read the question and make sure you do what they're asking you to do, whatever they're asking you to do. That's how you create a new document preset, okay? Guys, you can also come here, new. There's your new document preset, right? That's how you can name it right here. Again, they'll tell you to name it animals or something like that. They'll tell you exactly what to do down here. Just don't rush. Take your time. Reread the question a few times, right? Make sure you have everything set before you hit OK, right? Well, there's the default preset. There's my new animals preset, right? That's how you do it, guys. That's how you do it. Right, next thing, they may ask you to create a new document. Easy, file, new. If you have a hard time getting over here, remember they have a shortcut for Control N to create a new document, right? Again, guys, they will tell you the name. They will give you the width and the height. They'll give you all the specifications, but this question is mostly about either having a primary text frame or not having a primary text frame, right? If that is not checked, your document will not have a primary text frame. If I check that and then hit OK, my document's gonna have a primary text frame. That means the text frame's kinda already there. I can get my type tool, right? And then I can start typing. Boom, primary text frame, right? So again, easy guys, file, new. They'll either tell you it should have a primary text frame or it should not have a primary text frame. So again, when this dialog box opens, you either check or uncheck that box, right? That's how you do it, guys. Real easy, real easy. All right, let's keep moving, let's keep moving. All right. Guys, they may give you a document. It may have some images and text on the top and the bottom. They'll have some guides set up that leave these areas. I can't remember if they have it grayed out for you or not, but they'll tell you to create some rectangular frames in between the guides to use as placeholders, right? So these are our shapes. These are our frames, okay? They should tell you to do a rectangular frame. They tell you to do another kind of frame like ellipse or polygon, do that, right? All I gotta do is come in here, make sure I'm within those guides that they have set up for me, and I'm gonna click and drag a frame, right? If you see those X's, you have a placeholder frame. What can we place in there? We can place solid colors, gradient colors, patterns, but mostly we place images, right? So now I've got three frames, they can be used as placeholders. I can send this to my partner or my teammate or my boss. They can click in that frame and they can add in whatever content they want. All right. All right, guys, you're gonna need to apply object styles or create object styles or possibly delete a object style, right? Whatever they tell you to do, right? We need to know that we have a window for styles And that window for styles holds our cell styles, character styles, object styles, paragraph styles, table styles. Guys, if you know how to do one style, you should be able to do the rest, right? Styles are like clothes that we put on. It's like the drip we take out of our closet and put on our bodies, right? We all have different styles. Maybe we dress different styles for different days. If you can do a character style, you can do an object style. You can do an object style, you can do a paragraph style, okay? So let's open up our object style, right? Guys, they could tell you to create a new style based off something else, right? So maybe I move this stuff over here. Maybe I click on that, right? Create a new style based off that. They'll tell you what to name it. Get my window from this other monitor over here. Right? So guys, they'll tell you, right? Draft, whatever. They'll tell you what to base it on. Guys, they could tell you to add a drop shadow. They do. Add whatever they tell you. Inner shadow, outer glow. Guys, whatever it is that they ask you to do, that's what you do, right? Just reread the question. Make sure you put in everything they tell you to put in. Okay, now I have a giraffe style here, right? I could click on one of these frames over here, and then I could apply that giraffe style, right? Boom. Now I created a giraffe style. It was based on green. I applied it to this one, right? So guys, you just need to know where the styles are found. Their panels, styles category, object styles, character styles, right? You can do a character style, right? Maybe we pick this. We got a certain font, we got a size, right? We got everything we want. We can create a new style based off that. We can name that, whatever they tell us to name it, right? We do whatever else they tell us to do. Right, now I have a new style. I can apply it somewhere else. Boom. See how that works? All right. So guys, don't forget to practice your styles, character styles and object styles. All right, guys, again, like I said before, make sure you're familiar with your swatches. They're found under window and color. Right? You need to know how to create new swatches, how to edit swatches, how to delete swatches. Like I said in the last video, you can select all the unused, right? There's all kind of stuff you can do in here. So make sure you're familiar with your swatches. Yeah. All right, guys, they may tell you to center the registration of an image and flip it, right? So what do we need to do? We need to click on the image, right? I'm on the image. Let's say the reference point is over here. Well, what they're asking you to do in the question is select the image and come up here and click the middle. They want the reference point in the middle. If you're taking the test and they tell you to put it in the middle and it's already in the middle, just click there again. Just click there again so they know you know where to go. Okay? And then to flip it, everything in InDesign's an object. Everything's an object. Images are objects, shapes are objects, text is objects. So I'm gonna go to Object, Transform. Think of the Transformers movies, right? They're robots from outer space that can transform into cars and vehicles and assault weapons, all kind of stuff, right? So you're changing a image. In this case, we're just going to flip it horizontal. Guys, they could tell you to flip it vertical. They could tell you to rotate something, right? You just need to know that all that stuff is found here under Object and Transform, right? Now it's flipped. Boom. Easy. Okay. All right. Guys, again, make sure you know everything about your pre-flight profile. Again, that's when we output to a printer. We have to pay a printing house to print this, right? Got to go to our pre-flight panel and see if there's any errors, right? I don't have any errors right now. In the last video, I showed you if you had any errors, you could address them here. They'll tell you in the info exactly what to do, right? Guys, there could be a question where they tell you to turn the pre-flight off. You just need to uncheck that box. They tell you to turn the pre-flight on. You need to check that box, right? Guys, there are some profiles under here. You got to know that you could come to these lines and define a new profile, right? They may ask you to define a new profile. Guys, just click on that and then do whatever they tell you to do. They tell you to include the images and objects, right? Click on that. I can't click on it because I don't have that stuff right now, right? But you just need to know where to go. If you're not sure where to go, check these lines, right? All these panels have these lines. Just check there. Okay, so make sure you understand all your pre-flight stuff. All right. All right, guys, they may tell you to move some pages or swap some pages. Right now, I don't have any pages, but they may ask you to add some pages. So let's do that, and then we can swap some of these pages around, right? So right now, I just got one page design. Guys, think about it. What would make sense? What would make sense if I wanted to alter my layout or add pages? Oh, layout. Wow, let's try layout. Wow, look right there at the top. Pages. I can add a page. Oh, come on. Layout, pages. I can add a page, insert a page. I can move pages. I can duplicate a spread, right? I can apply master to certain pages. Guys, again, you do whatever they tell you to do on the test, right? So maybe I want to insert some pages, right? How many? Maybe 30. Maybe they tell me on the exam to add 30 pages. And maybe they tell me to add it after page one or before page one or at the start of the document. Guys, just click around on these drop downs and look for stuff. Again, reread the question and do whatever it is they tell you to do, okay? Boom. Now I should have 31 pages now, right? There's page one. Look at all those pages. Look at all those pages. Now they're not side by side because I did not create facing pages. Okay, so guys, now look, if they want you to swap pages, you could do it right here in this pages window, right? Maybe you click on page one and move it down to page two. Maybe you apply page one to page two, right? Click and drag this and apply it to page four, right? Again, I can swap pages, put them in different locations. Right. So guys, you just need to be familiar with your pages panel. Look, there's a garbage can. You can delete things. Look, there's a plus. You can create a new page here. Right. Probably can come up to these lines and create a new page here. Look, insert pages, move pages, new master. Right. I can do it here under these lines. I can do it down here with these icons. I can do it up here under layout pages. Guys, Adobe offers you preferences. They offer you multiple ways to do the same thing, okay? So make sure you know how to swap pages. Make sure you know how to apply masters to pages, right? Get in there and practice all that stuff. Since I swapped page one and two, I should be able to scroll down, and then there's that information. Again, if I take this and drag it to page three, I can scroll down and look on page three. There's all my stuff. Maybe I want to delete this page. Boom. Yes, I want to delete it. Boom, it's gone. It's not there anymore. So, guys, make sure you understand your pages. All right, guys, I think that's it. Again, you probably will receive some things on the test that I have not gone over in the videos or on G-Metrics. Guys, just use your brain. Be intelligent like you are. Click around. Look at menus. Right? Open flyouts. Right? Practice, practice, practice. Get your hands dirty. You're going to pass this exam.